This is Matt Gardening and I am Vijay. Today we are going to grow rich gourd, that is peerkangai from seeds. It is a Chinese or Asian vegetable which is mostly used in Asian dishes, which is very tasty. So I prefer to grow it at my home garden. So let's get started.
Before entering into the video, subscribe to my channel if not yet subscribed, press the bell notification to get more video notifications and like and share it on your social media. First, let's look at the time to sow the seeds in each regions. If you live in a warm place like mine, I live in the South India. If you live in a place like tropics or subtropics, you must sow the seeds in spring, winter and the fall. You must not sow them in summer, but you can grow them during the summer. If you sow these in late spring, they will grow throughout the summer. So you can grow these all year round in these warm climatic region, but you must sow in these three time, that is fall, spring and winter, and not during summer.
It can also be sown in late summer, that is the June.
The next region is cold climatic region. If you live in a cold climatic region, you must sow these seeds in late spring and get the harvest in the mid of spring, summer or late summer. And you can sow the seeds in late summer and get the harvest in fall or early winter.
For this, I have soaked the seeds for 48 hours so that the pretty hard shell case softens and makes the plant to grow very well.
So now I'm going to give you two tips, that is the soaking method and paper towel method of growing seeds. These types of growing seeds will help you to germinate the seeds faster. This will help in the growth of melons and also the germination of gourds like bitter gourd, rich gourd, bitter melon, watermelon and cantaloupe, any more fruits like them. The first tip is soaking seeds. Soaking seeds for overnight to 48 hours is advised. Soaking more than that would cause fungal growth and make the seed to die. So it is hard for newbie gardeners. If you are a new gardener, then try the second method, which will be much more easier. The next tip is the paper towel method of germination. In this method, you can take some seeds and place it on a tissue paper or a paper towel and just fold the paper and just spray some water over it, or you can also add some water with a bottle, then place it in an airtight container and store it for 3 to 4 days in a place where they get morning and evening sunlight, that is partial shade. After 3 to 4 days you can see the sprouts. After that you can change the plant into the soil directly by placing the root downwards and the nodules or the cotyledons upward. It will grow within a week or so. By this the plant will grow very fast by making the time of germination lesser. You have to make some holes in the soil. So for this, I'm sowing one seed into the soil. So you can sow two seeds in bigger pot. This is a very big plant, so sow only two seeds in each pot. Immediately after sowing, water the plants so that they can germinate fast. Soil. The soil must be rich in nutrient, loamy, soft, and the roots have to grow deep enough, so that you must take more soil with high nutrition. They require a lot of nutrition and the moisture content of the soil must be high so that they can grow big fruits. These contains a lot of water in the soil. So try to give them a lot of water. Add cocopeat so that they can store water for the plant to grow, because this summer can be tolerated by these plants. So add some cocopeat and the plant itself contains a lot of water. With the fruit has the maximum content of water. So that doesn't mean of all fruits and vegetables, it has a high content of water in the fruit
or vegetable. So try to add a lot of cocopeat so that it will store water for the plant to grow. At least 5 gallons so that they can grow enough. The root has to grow big. They need a lot of nutrition. So to add that nutrition, you need a lot of soil. So for that, you need to give them a big container. This is a very big plant. So give them a big container so that they can grow well and flourish well. Sunlight. They require a lot of sunlight to form big fruits or vegetables. So that they can form their fruits earlier. So place the plant in an area where they get 5 to 6 hours of direct sunlight. 5 to 6 hours is enough because now it's going to be a very hard summer. So give them 5 to 6 hours of direct sunlight. Not 6 to 8 hours, 5 to 6 hours of direct sunlight is enough to grow those fruits. And in winters, if you are growing to grow in winters, try to grow in, then place it in a place where they get 6 to 8 hours of direct sunlight. Try to give them watering in morning and evening, twice a day, because these love water. This plant has a water content in the fruit, in the vegetable. Sorry, it's a vegetable. It has a lot of water content in the vegetable. So give them a lot of water during these summers. This is going to be a very hot summer, so try to give them water daily twice. In winters, you can give them as frequently as 2 days once, or in rainy season 2 days once. In winters, try to give them daily once. Not in winters, I'm saying about spring or in fall. You can give two days once or daily once. That will be enough. But during this harsh summer, give them twice daily. Affected by insects, so try to give them neem oil as soon as they get 2 leaves. They get mostly leaf miners. If you watch my leaf miner video, you will understand about this. You can see in the right side corner of this video above. So you will get the link in the right side corner. Watch that and understand about leaf miners. So they are adversely affected by leaf miners than any other insects. They may also get ants. So try to add neem oil and wood ash, which will be an effective pesticide for this.
The next heading is the diseases. These plants are adversely affected by many diseases like powdery mildew, downy mildew, etc. by these consequences like watering on leaves on evening and not giving enough sunlight, like 4 to 5 hours of direct sunlight is necessary in harsh summers and 6 to 8 hours of direct sunlight is necessary in cold times or not regular times. If you give low sunlight, then they may also get these diseases. And in rainy seasons also, you can see these diseases. Apply some milk in 50-50 ratio with water and give it on the leaves. Spray it on the leaves, then these diseases may be avoided. And these may be avoided and these can be abolished by giving 50-50 ratio of milk with water on the. This is also caused by crowding of plants, so don't crowd your plants nearby and leave space for them. And you can also use baking soda, 1 teaspoon of baking soda to 1 liter of water, and spray it on your plants, which will also be a good remedy. The next heading is the pollination. If there are lack of pollinators in your area, you can try hand pollinating them. In the image you see, there are two flowers, that is the male and female. The female has the ovary underneath and the male doesn't have. You can see the image. So pluck the male flower from the plant and tap it over the female flower by facing it towards the female and tap it gently. The pollen will get transferred and you will get more fruits. The next heading is fertilization. You must add bone meal and eggshell for more flowers and more bloom at starting itself. These are slow release fertilizers, so add in the soil itself. They will get decomposed and will be got by the plants when they are flowering. You should add manures and compost at starting at the first month after sowing so that they can grow green lush plant, and at end they will bloom well. And at some times you can use the eggshell boiled water as a fertilizer. You can also use bone meal, and also you can also use blood meal, which is good for more flowers and more blooms.
You must also add banana peel fertilizers, and compost made by banana peels. You can also use fish emulsion, which is a liquid fertilizer. You must use these in 15 days once, any of them 15 days once. You must give these fertilizers 15 days once, any of them first 15th day, and the next 15th day other fertilizer, and the next 15th day another fertilizer, so that they can get all the required nutrients. Video will be useful to you. Grow these rich gourds in your garden and get a bountiful harvest. Happy gardening! Like, share and subscribe to my channel, and press the bell notification to get notified about my upcoming videos. Happy.